हेलो हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। एज यू नो इन अवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई हैव गिवन यू आइडिया रिगार्डिंग इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ह्यूमन ब्रेन एंड द फंक्शंस एंड सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ वेरियस पार्ट ऑफ द ब्रेन। नाउ Before we start today's lecture number 4, in chapter number 7, today is our lecture number 4, okay? I want to give you an idea regarding hormones. You all know one thing very well, that all activities are controlled and coordinated in our body, not only by our brain, not only by CNS and PNS, central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. All our activities are controlled and coordinated by our brain, spinal cord and nerves. But at the same time, there is also an important role of various hormones. Hormone, as you know, chemical messengers. There is also an important role of hormones in our body for controlling various metabolic reactions in our body. So in our today's lecture, our target is to study about human endocrine system. That is, first let me write the title: human endocrine system. Okay, what does it mean? Let us explain you first. Endocrine means what? So just try to understand. In our body there are two type of ducts, two type of glands which secrete particular type of hormones. Now in our body some glands, understand, are called exocrine glands. Exocrine means they are situated in that place where they secrete hormone and utilized at that place only. Means the site of production and the site of application are same. So that we call exocrine glands. Understand? Like suppose salivary gland, the one type of exocrine gland, because it is situated in our buccal cavity, secretes saliva. That saliva plays a very important role in the process of digestion, you all know very well. So that is exocrine gland. But there are some glands in our body which secrete hormone in our bloodstream, and via bloodstream those hormones reach to each and every part of our body. They are known as endocrine glands. Today we are trying to study human endocrine system, and we are trying to study various type of endocrine glands in human. Understood? First you understood there are two type of glands in our body. Which two type of glands are there in our body? Two type of glands. Glands are actually those tubes which secrete particular type of hormones. Two types of glands are there in our body. One are called exocrine glands, okay, and another are called endocrine glands, right? Exocrine glands, I gave you an example, they secrete hormone at the same place where it is to be applicable, it is to be utilized. But endocrine glands secrete hormone directly in our bloodstream. and via bloodstream that hormone transfers to all parts of our body. So today we are going to study about human endocrine system. So many endocrine glands are there in our body. Some glands are situated in our head region. Like take an example, pineal gland. In previous lecture I gave you an idea regarding few glands like pituitary gland, hypothalamus gland, thalamus gland, which is actually a part of our brain. Understood? So in our head region there are some glands which are situated, means they are confined to our head region, like pineal gland, pituitary gland, thalamus gland, hypothalamus gland. Then in our neck region we have got thyroid gland. Then just understand, in our respiratory tract near trachea we have got thymus gland. Then near our stomach, pancreas is also one of the endocrine glands, understand, which secrete insulin hormone. Then adrenal gland, as I taught you while we were discussing about the human excretory system, a pair of gland just lie above our pair of kidneys, adrenal gland. Then in male, testes, and in female, ovary. This many endocrine glands are present in our body. Okay, we are just trying to understand importance of each and every gland in our body. Okay, in exam sometime they may ask you, okay, draw human endocrine system. So simple diagram you can draw about human endocrine system. Okay, just try with me. Not so complicated diagram it is actually. Suppose head region. Okay, just draw a simple diagram itself. Okay, simple diagram is sufficient. So some shoulder region, okay, and then from here okay, simple diagram is sufficient for this. Do not have to think too much. And somewhat this is enough. Okay, head region a little bigger. Okay, right, and here is all okay. Now suppose this is human body and we want to show various type of endocrine glands which are actually responsible for secreting hormones in our body. Understand, the first tentative diagram of brain, as you know, just a simple diagram of brain we have drawn. Understand, and here you have to, if you can remember, three glands you have to show. 1, 2, 3. and another gland which I can show here. Okay, just try to understand it. Four glands naming one is pineal gland, then thalamus, hypothalamus and pituitary glands. Okay, then in our neck region, just here sufficient, in our neck region, neck thoda motu banao, in our neck region there is also one gland. Okay, that also we will show in our neck region. Then here one another gland. Okay, then as you know lungs, so you know that. Okay, now suppose here near stomach, you must be knowing the name of that endocrine glands, as you know, known as pancreas. Okay, then after pancreas, kidney, name of the glands you are knowing. On our kidney, a concept glands. Okay, on kidney, and then in female ovaries, and in male testes. Okay, this is the diagram you can show. Okay, simple diagram is sufficient to show this. Okay, moment this way also you can show. Okay, now see, let us try to understand importance of each and every gland. Okay, first name of this gland is pineal gland. Pineal gland. Then we have thalamus gland. Then we have this one, you can call it hypothalamus gland. Okay, this is thalamus gland. Then this is actually, as we have shown this in the diagram of brain, this is pituitary gland. Okay, then here in our neck region lies one gland which we call thyroid gland. Thyroid gland, these are all endocrine glands we are showing. Then here in our chest region is thymus gland. Thymus, little big writing so that you can see it. Thymus gland. Then as you know, pancreas. Okay, then a pair of glands, this is known as adrenal glands. Adrenal gland. Then in female, a pair of ovary, and in male, pair of testes. This many endocrine glands you have to show in exam. Okay, and let us try to understand importance of all endocrine glands in our body, what is their importance actually? There is no importance of pineal gland, thalamus gland has been explained. Even there is no mention of hypothalamus gland in your textbook. Understand? Even not of pituitary gland, but I must explain you that hypothalamus gland is actually a very, very important gland in human body. Why? Because most of the glands, most of, are working under the control of pituitary gland, my dear student. Actually, such a small, tiny glands is actually the master gland in our body. It controls the function of thyroid gland, it controls the function of ovary, understand? It controls even the function of mammary gland, understand, in female body. So actually, pituitary gland is very important. It is called the master gland in our body. Now actually what happens? This pituitary gland actually secretes so many type of hormones. But this pituitary gland is actually under the control of hypothalamus gland, because hypothalamus gland secrete particular type of hormones which are actually called releasing hormone or RH hormone. Dear student, you should just note down. You do not have to study in detail about that, but they are called releasing hormone. All releasing hormone are secreted from hypothalamus gland. This releasing hormone secreted from hypothalamus gland actually affect various regions of pituitary gland and forces pituitary gland to secrete various types of hormones. So many hormones are secreted by pituitary gland. Understand, there is no mention of all hormones in your textbook, but I just mentioned, and in exam also you do not have to mention anything which is not a part of your textbook. But pituitary gland, which actually pituitary gland is divided into three regions: anterior region, intermediate region and outer region. These three regions of pituitary gland secretes particular type of hormones. Like pituitary gland secrete one of the hormone name, if I mention TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone. Name itself gives you an idea. It will stimulate thyroid gland. Just understand. TSH secreted by pituitary gland actually makes thyroid gland active, so that thyroid gland secretes its particular type of hormone. At the same time, pituitary gland also secrete FSH, LTH. FSH means follicle stimulating hormone. I am not noting down this point because it's not in the textbook, just explaining FSH, follicle stimulating hormone, which will stimulate the female ovary and control the process of starting the ovulation, and it has control on the process of ovary. So that is follicle stimulating hormone. Pituitary gland also secrete hormone like LTH, luteinizing hormone, which play a very important role in the development of mammary gland and breast development in girl when they attain the age of puberty or adulthood. So LTH hormone, there are so many hormones: ACTH hormone, adrenocorticotropic hormone, that is also secreted by pituitary gland. Okay, actually in textbook they haven't mentioned the importance of all these hormones like TSH, LTH, ACTH, FSH. I just explained. In addition, pituitary gland also secrete hormone like ADH, means anti-diuretic hormone. At the same time, it also secrete oxytocin, vasopressin. So many hormones are secreted by pituitary gland, but one of the hormone we secreted by pituitary gland, which we have to discuss in quite detail, is known as, and it has been also mentioned in detail in textbook, that is called growth hormone. Try to understand. This hormone secreted by pituitary gland is also known as GH, growth hormone, also known as GH. Just try to understand importance of secretion of growth hormone in regular manner is very, very important. Another hormone, should I mention this for you? ACTH, can you remember? FSH, LTH, understand? Then I write TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone. These are the hormones of pituitary gland. Then ADH, anti-diuretic hormone. Then oxytocin, okay. Then vasopressin. All these are actually a list of hormones secreted by pituitary gland. Understand, all hormones are secreted by actually pituitary gland. But growth hormone we have to discuss in detail, because regular secretion of growth hormone is a must. A irregular and abnormal secretion of growth hormone will directly affect the growth of human being. Let us discuss how it affects the growth of human being. Just try to understand, irregular secretion of growth hormone results, understand, in human being, it can be, it actually expresses itself in three ways in human being. Just try to understand. If in biology, when you want to speak excess secretion of hormone, in biology the word is hypersecretion. I am not noting down everything, but you can mention. If hyposecretion of growth hormone take place, hypo means excess secretion, that you all know. If hyposecretion or excess secretion of growth hormone take place in human being, then what happens? It result in sudden enlargement of the body part. That means the height of the person may be abnormal looking. Understand, maybe 8 feet, 7 feet, like that. And that is known as, that is one of the diseases known as gigantism. Understand? Right? So, over secretion or hyposecretion of growth hormone results in excess increase in the height of a person, which doesn't look normal. Understand? So, that is called gigantism. Doesn't mean that all taller person are suffering from gigantism. Mind it. Understand, when the person is suffering from gigantism, though his height is incredibly more, but at the same time he may be suffering from lots of joint pain, bone problems, etc. So that is when this is called gigantism. Now if it happens that pituitary gland is not able to secrete hormone in sufficient necessary adequate amount. Means in biology I can say that way in excess of secretion, which word I utilized? Hyper secretion. Now I am cutting that word, I am speaking another word, hyposecretion. Hyposecretion means what? Less secretion. So if hyposecretion of growth hormone occurs in the body of any person, then his all-round growth is suddenly stopped, and even age physical growth occurs horizontally, but the person remains short-heighted. Understand? Throughout the life, means up till some age, pachi to growth stop thai, as you know. So that disease is known as dwarfism. What is that disease known as? Dwarfism. Understand? So hyposecretion of growth hormone results in another disease in a person, which we call dwarfism. Dwarfism means short-heighted. Doesn't mean that all short-heighted people are suffering from dwarfism. Understand? So many students are studying with you who are low-heighted. That is their parental hereditary character. So don't start speaking like you are a dwarf person. Understand? Dwarfism is one ultimately disease which take place, which occurs in the body of human being by what? By the hyposecretion. That means the less secretion of growth hormone. First one, what we spoke? Hypersecretion, that word we utilize. Hyper means excess secretion of growth hormone results in which disease? That is called gigantism. Understand? Gigantism means incredible increase in the height of a person, but he may be suffering from many pains. Understand? Hyposecretion means the less secretion of, again, growth hormone result in dwarfism of a person. Dwarfism means person may remain short-heighted. Now, if it occurs that sometime the secretion of growth hormone increases and sometime the secretion of growth hormone decreases, try to understand. Sometime the secretion of growth hormone increases and sometimes the secretion of growth hormone decreases, means the secretion of growth hormone is irregular ultimately. Then at that time, what happened? Sometime hyposecretion, sometime hypersecretion, means sometime excess secretion, sometime less secretion. So as a result, what can happen? When such type of irregularity in secretion of growth hormone take place, understand, it also expresses itself in a person by one disease called, the name of that disease is a particular name I should mention. One disease, as I told you, that is, you must be knowing, hypersecretion of growth hormone, it results in which disease? Gigantism, as you know. Second one, by less secretion, hyposecretion, it result in a disease called dwarfism. Understand? That means the person remains short-heighted, and this disease occurs due to irregular secretion of growth hormone, which we call acromegaly disease. What happens in this disease? You can see the person in front of you, and if you try to look at his fingers or forelimb, that is hands, understand, it looks like compared to the body, if you see his head as well as his finger, they are abnormally looking larger, like just the look of the person is like a gorilla. Not exactly gorilla, But if you have seen the gorilla, what happens? Its body stature looks smaller, but the head region and the finger, means the fingers and thumb, are larger. So that person, if you just look at him, understand, so you will feel some abnormality in the growth of the some organs, understand, compared to the whole body stature. Mostly it is seen in the big head region and more large fingers, understand. So that is actually known as one disease which we call acromegaly disease, understand. So these three hormones and their effects has been discussed in detail in your textbook. Other hormone I just mentioned, ACTH, adrenocorticotropic hormone, follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone, thyroid stimulating hormone, antidiuretic hormone, oxytocin hormone, vasopressin hormone. The role of all these hormones hasn't been mentioned in your textbook, so you do not have to even remember their name and their significance in our body, but you have to remember about growth hormone in quite detail. That is a must, understood. So we discuss about pituitary gland, which is the master gland, but that master is controlled by another master, that is hypothalamus gland, understand. Pineal gland is also plays a good role, understand, in metabolism, and it is so tiny. All these actually glands are so tiny, and they are just near our brain, near ear, understand. They are quite near to, so any operation of nasal or ear can sometimes may affect, understand, this gland also. Then thyroid gland situated in our neck region. Importance of thyroid you have to discuss. Let us discuss it in detail, my dear student. Let me explain you. Have you heard this word in your relative? Like suppose you might have heard the word somebody speaking out, ke bhai ene thyroid chhe. You heard this word? You must have. Thyroid means the person who has thyroid, how can it be visualized? So generally he perspire a lot. Lots of perspiration take place in his body. Not only that, the body weight increases. Even he is dieting, the body weight increases. Sometimes respiratory rate also increases frequently. So these are some symptoms, understand, of this gland, thyroid gland. Actually, what happens, let us try to understand. Your daily food, our daily food consists of few components of food: carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, mineral, water and lipids. Now our body require all minerals in adequate amount, in proper amount, sufficient amount in our body. You need to take iodine regularly in your body by eating iodine containing substances. You are also have heard the advertisement, iodized table salt. What does it mean? What it suggests? It suggests the importance of iodine in our body. So if your daily intake contain sufficient amount of iodine, then that iodine is utilized by thyroid gland for process of manufacturing thyroxine hormone in our body. And that thyroxine hormone, which is secreted by or produced by thyroid gland, understand, regulate all metabolism in our body. And it is very, very important, understand, for proper growth and development of our body. It is necessary for our all-round physical and mental development. but for production of thyroxine hormone by thyroid gland, which raw material you require to supplement that is iodine intake in your daily diet. If your daily diet does not contain sufficient amount of iodine, then thyroid gland does not get enough raw material for the production of thyroxine hormone. And when thyroxine hormone is not produced, it will disturb your regular metabolism, may affect your all-round physical and mental development also. Sometimes extreme thyroid may result in bulging of your eyes also. Bulging eye means quite smaller eye. Understand bulging eye. That is also one of the simple, very serious type of thyroid disease. Actually, the disease which arises due to insufficient secretion of thyroxine hormone, I am not noting down, you should note down, that is called goiter, G-O-I-T-E-R. That is a disease arising due to insufficient secretion of thyroxine hormone in our body. What are the symptoms of goiter that I already explained you? All over mental and physical development has been altered. Not at the same time our regular metabolism is disturbed. At the same time you will see actually thyroid gland increases in size to secrete more and more hormone. Even the raw material is not available from your daily diet, it increases, and as a result it can, because the size of the thyroid gland increases, it also result in outer view the swelling of your neck region. Your neck region swells, it becomes bigger, because inside the neck region thyroid gland is actually increasing in size. So that is one type of disease which we call goiter disease. So our daily diet needs to have sufficient amount of iodine. Understand? Then come to pancreas. My dear student, you all know very well the role of pancreas. You must be knowing role of pancreas. Understand? You all know, right? Pancreas secretes which hormone? We already studied. Understand? In digestive system, if you can remember, I told you ATL, amylase, trypsin, lipase. But here one another thing. Actually, pancreas secretes a particular type of hormone which you may have come across many times with name called insulin hormone. What is the role of insulin? To control your sugar level in your blood. Sugar level in blood needs to be controlled. Understand? If it increases, as you know, due to improper secretion of insulin, which is actually a factor which control your blood sugar level, then a person may suffer from diabetes, that you all know. And a diabetic person has to take either the tablet or injection of insulin hormone, that you all know. Some people are also taking some tablet like glucotrol to control the diabetes, to control the sugar level. But if higher diabetes, then you necessarily have to take insulin hormone before every diet. Either before your breakfast, before your lunch, before your dinner, when you eat anything before that, you have to take an insulin injections in your body. Understand? To control the blood sugar level. The importance of pancreas is very much in our body because it controls blood sugar level. Understand? And if the secretion of insulin is not sufficient, that result in high sugar level in blood, which is called diabetes. And if you get infected by this disease, diabetes, it is going to affect all rest of the organ in your body. It may affect your eye, it may affect your heart, it may affect your liver, your kidney, all are affected by this one disease, diabetes, okay? Adrenal gland. See, actually, adrenal gland, see, we have shown here, are in pair and present on the kidney. Actually, these are kidney and adrenal glands are there. What is the role of adrenal gland? Actually, adrenal gland is known as glands of flight or fight. Can you differentiate between these two words, flight and fight? Fight means hormones secreted by these particular glands makes a person or prepare person for fight. Fight doesn't mean wrestling. It prepare person for facing any type of situation. Understand? At the same time, if this hormone secreted by adrenal gland also gives you a mode of flight, means you lose your thinking power. Actually, what happens? It means this gland is also called the gland of emergency. Understand what happens? Which hormone is secreted by adrenal gland? The name of hormone is very important. You should note down adrenaline hormone. Understand? This adrenaline hormone secreted by adrenal gland is known as hormones of emergency. Why? Why they are known as hormones of emergency? Because adrenaline hormone secreted by adrenaline gland directly affects first heart. It makes the heart to start working faster. Means each and every cell of muscle, means the because the heart start pumping faster, blood flow increases in each and every organ of our body. Each and every organ of our body start receiving more oxygen. Understand, it will also increase your respiratory rate. Means just secretion of adrenaline hormone makes you ready to face any circumstances. Understand, that's why it is called hormones of emergency, hormones of flight or fight. And my dear student, you must have utilized this word so many times. Suppose in agar hum kahe to in Hindi or Gujarati we sometimes speak, apne na sometimes we utilize word ke bhai that person is always, is apne nahi kehta, we call it he is mentally stronger and in any situation he can face it. And at the same time we see some person, we call it ke bhai you are very coward, you are not able to face a simple minor problem. Two types of person. So actually the nature of the person, understand, is actually the secretion, it suggests the secretion of adrenaline hormone. This secretion of adrenaline hormone may vary from person to person and it give you a different capacity to fight or face any situation. That's why, means any situation or any circumstances, that's why we call it hormones of emergency, hormones of flight or fight. No doubt, also another hormone are also secreted by adrenal gland for the proper maintenance of some iron balance and water balance in our body, but it's not a part of your study. You just have to remember that hormone secreted by adrenal glands are called hormones of flight or fight, hormones of emergency. These glands are also very important. Understand? Then comes ovary. you have also studied somewhere in primary ovaries, or I have shown both that actually glands here, ovaries are a pair of tissue present in female, not male. What is the function of ovary? It secretes two types of hormone, as you all know, estrogen and progesterone hormone. Name are also mentioned in textbook and in material also. Estrogen, somewhere in primary also you got the idea about this hormone, estrogen and progesterone hormone. What's the role of this hormone? This hormone play a great role, understand, in girls actually. At the age of puberty, when the secretion of this this hormone, understand, start, that is estrogen and progesterone hormone, it actually help in development of all secondary sex character in female, like sweetening and softening of her voice. At the same time, development of mammary gland. At the same time, development of uterus, understand, and at the same time it start the process of help in starting the process of ovulation, that is the production of ovule in female ovary, which is known as female reproductive cell. So these two hormones, estrogen and progesterone, are also very very important, understand, in female body. The role I just explained, help in help in development of secondary sexual character, I mentioned all. At the same time I forget to mention one, that is, it also secretion of this hormone start feeling of attraction for the opposite sex. Female start feeling attraction for male, understand. Now testis, a pair of testes are all present only in male, and this pair of testes secrete the hormone which you also must be have studied somewhere, that is testosterone hormone. This testosterone hormone is responsible for starting, understand, the process of spermatogenesis, that means the production of sperm, that is male reproductive cell, in the body of a male. Not only it helps in starting the process of spermatogenesis, but at the same time it also develops the secondary sexual characters in male, like deepening and thickening of voice, developing of man apple here. At the same time, feeling a growing beard, mustache, growing chest hair, pubic hair. In female also, the growing of pubic hair is also one of the secondary sexual character. Pubic hair means the hair, minute small hair around your reproductive organ. Understand? In male, hair on chest and hair around the reproductive organ, that is also one of the secondary sexual character develop in man, understand. And not only that, the man also start looking little muscular, understand. So that is also one of the symptom, and he start feeling attraction, more attraction for the opposite sex. So that is the role of testes, understand. So we explain role of all tissues, understand, in our body, right? Starting from pineal, thalamus, hypothalamus, pituitary gland, thyroid gland, thymus gland, pancreas, adrenal gland, ovary and testes. And I explained the role of each and every tissues, or each and every glands. How many glands occur in pair? Do pineal gland? No, single. Thalamus, single. Hypothalamus, single. Pituitary, single. Pancreas, single. Perma, adrenal gland, ovary and testes, they occur in pair, understand, in our body. So we explain you the importance of each and every gland in our body. understood. So this way, in exam, it can be asked to you to explain, or you may be asked in exam, just draw human endocrine system. That's why we are drawing diagram on the board, so that it can be asked in exam just to draw a neat and labeled diagram of human endocrine system. You may be asked a question of 5 marks that draw neat and labeled diagram of human endocrine system and explain the function of each and every hormone. It can be asked in exam, understand? So today we explain you the importance of all endocrine glands and hormones secreted by endocrine glands. You understood? Okay. Mostly, chapter number 7, we took 4 lectures to complete it. In the first lecture, I explained you control and coordination in plant. Then in the lecture number 2, I explained you the working of nerve cell and nerves in our body. I explained you the reflex action. Then in the third lecture, I explained you the internal structure of human brain and how various parts work. And in this lecture, I explained you the importance of various endocrine glands and various hormones secreted by them. Understood? My dear student, every time I am telling you that good diagram and principally good diagram carries good marks in biology, not in biology, even physics, chemistry also. Good diagram always fetches a good mark, but at the same time I again and again asking you, the content level has to be very accurate, understand? It has to be accurate and glossy. Your content has to be perfect. You should be sure about what you are writing. Understand? In science, when we meet live at that time also we will discuss, understand? But in science, and I have seen some student in test and I am reported that they are writing short note but they are missing the main content, so that is not proper. In science, the length of the answer is not important. What important is the fact you are writing. Understand? So in science, stick to the fact rather than concentrating on lengthening our answer. Lengthening of answer is not is going to serve your purpose for fetching good mark. It is actually, you are just making it irritating and boring for the person who is checking your paper. You need to be very point wise, you need to be very contentful in your answer. That is what we require, understand? So my dear student, today in our lecture number 4, we are completing the topic of human endocrine system and the process of all various type of hormone secreted by various glands. Understood? So today's lecture, before we end, chapter number 7 is over. Understand? Chapter 6 and 7 both of biology we explained to you. Okay, I hope and expect that you must have understood each and every detail which I am sharing with you. Okay, thank you very much for attending today's lecture from Bharat sir. Thank you very much, my dear student.